मॉड्यूल 7 लीनो इचिंग कलर प्रिंट रिडक्शन ब्लॉक प्रिंटिंग एपरेटस एंड मटेरियल्स। लीनो ब्लॉक साइज 7 इंचेस × 7 इंचेस, थिकनेस 1 इंचेस, ट्रेसिंग एंड कार्बन पेपर, रबर रोलर और प्रेयर 8 इंचेस, ब्लैक प्रिंटिंग इंक 3 प्रिंटिंग इंक्स, इंकिंग नाइफ, इंकिंग ग्लास, पेपर फॉर प्रिंटिंग, कॉटन रैक्स एंड केरोसिन फॉर क्लीनिंग, स्पून एंड प्रिंटिंग मशीन, हैंड ग्लव्स, वुडन स्पून, लिनोरियम कटिंग टूल, सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड क्रिस्टल्स, ग्लास रॉड, वुडन स्टिक, पेंट ब्रश, प्रोटेक्टेड आई वियर, स्क्रब ब्रश, वैग और एल्मर ग्लू और एक्रेलिक मीडियम, हेयर ड्रायर, बाउल ऑफ कोल्ड वाटर। लिनोरियम हैज बीन यूज्ड एज अ प्रिंट मेकिंग मटेरियल फॉर ओवर 100 years नाउ, and the word linoleum dates back to 1863 when Frederick Walton of England combined the Latin word for flax, linum, with the Latin word for oil, oleum, to call it linoleum. It was created in the 1800s and used later for covering or lining of the floor. The surface is created using cork and linseed oil and works as a smoother, water-resistant surface as compared to other substances. It is used to line the floors of ships as the oily surface discourages water to soak the wood and cause decay. For the technique employed in relief printmaking, linoleum is used as a cheaper alternative to wood and metal. Take first color impression. A wide area exists in your design. Etch the first from block and take impression. Draw or trace the sketch on block. You can improve the sketch at the time of final drawing. Carving the soft surface is simpler, and most of the carving or etching or other wood print making techniques can be easily carried out on linoleum blocks or lino blocks. As we learned earlier about lino cuts in other module, the other apparent changes in technique developed over generations with the simple need to develop newer techniques in relief making. The lino blocks thus carved or etched can be seen gradually reducing in size, and this was termed as reduction block printing. When the relief surface is inked using a brayer or roller, the print made on paper is fine and clean. Cover or draw images with the black japan, protection from acid solution. Etching is a process in which lines or textures are bitten into or etched into the matrix or ground using a variety of mordants or acids. Though it sounds quite easy, the process requires a fair amount of deftness and absolute care while handling the acid component. The wax resist is used to define and contain the design on the lino sheet, so that the acid, which is in liquid form, does not run off the sides of the block. Linoleum sheets are often reinforced with wood baking and hence the chances of it bucking or bending with the acid effects are sought. Usually, the acid used is the determining factor of the amount of time to be allotted to the itching to happen. Unlike the linocut, the reduction print technique offers a lot less remnant of the block once the whole design is used up or eased out. The history of lino etching. The specific technique is rather difficult to trace, as the linocut process itself was developed and widely used after 1920s. The need to create relief surfaces with little grain or texture became at some point a task, as it was not easy to get a completely smooth print devoid of textural natural grain from woodcuts and wood-based relief printing. Metal was being simultaneously explored as a surface for printmaking, but it was much more expensive and experimentation had its limitations. Linoleum was one such cheaply available surface or ground which allowed experimentation and professional outputs, thereby becoming the most preferred medium for printmaking experimentations. The lino etching process is one such less explored technique which is in its developmental stages all over the world. Few artists are present who endorse this technique merely because of the variety of outputs it gives, with slight changes in timing of acid bite and even the quality of ground used or the specific acid used. For example, the acid when poured onto the lino block creates bubbles as the acid bites into the surface on the lino block. The acid action below the surface of the bubbles is reduced, hence it is imperative that these bubbles be brushed off so as to create action on the surface. The acid used also matters, as it affects the line of the eased design. Sodium hydroxide crystals, caustic soda, has a tendency to burn straight down into the block sideways too. As this affects the containment with wax resist, the block could buckle or become hollowed out from the design limits, giving a jagged edged print. The density of the ground, that is lino block, if uneven, could also pose a problem after acid is laid on the design and how to be carefully monitored. The action of hydrochloric acid is more controlled than that of nitric acid. Caustic soda and other alkaline solutions also are used as a mordant to etch lino blocks and gives a soft slow acting and controlled by it onto the desired areas. This etching of lino block is a very unpredictable technique, and at the same time that itself is its strong points. Relief printing is a subtractive printing process where areas meant not to print are physically removed. In this case, an alkali solution, sodium hydroxide, is used to produce a chemical etch that removes surface areas of the printing plate, producing an incised line. When the alkali solution comes in contact with the resin, in the linoleum, it produces recessed areas with a granule surface. Prepare etching solution, approximate 1 teaspoon sodium hydroxide with 200 ml water. The remaining areas that are in relief are the areas that will print. Materials most commonly used for this technique are caustic soda, lye, spray, oven cleaner, and other brands of sodium hydroxide crystals. Apply the etching solution with the help of different tools, knives, synthetic brushes, etc. After 5 minutes or take time as your design requirement, etch the negative image. Although all of these matters are technical, every single tool or material used has its own effects on the final print. The bite time of the mordant on the surface also needs to be experimented with, and the concentration of the solution is of importance too. A slight variation in any of these step-by-step movements could drastically change the output. To avoid any hazards, mistakes in the making of this solution, many printmakers have chosen to create a wheat paste with an acid or alkali which acts as an etchant to be applied onto the surface to be etched lino block. The methods of reduction printing have been evolved from the woodblock printing techniques, and it is quite similar to the process of using the very same block to use multiple colors for printing. In the lino etching technique, the lino block is progressively etched instead of cutting and carving, and after each etching, the block is inked in different colors and then print is taken. This process renders the lino block fragile after 3 colors have been printed. Here I am discussing about an eminent artist, Mr. Anand Nigam, who is also performing this exercise. He is born in 1962 in the village of Embejogai in the Bid district of Maharashtra. Artist and printmaker Anand Nigam completed his GD art in painting from the Government School of Art, Aurangabad. He moved to Mumbai for his further education after his graduation from Aurangabad. He later on went to complete his diploma A.Ed at Sir J.J. School of Art, Mumbai. Today he is the head of the Department of Printmaking at the prestigious Sir J.J. School of Arts, Mumbai. In Aurangabad, he studied under the able guidance of Professor Vasant Parab and Vaman Chincholkar. Having apprenticed and witnessed the genius of Krishna Reddy's printmaking workshops and seminars while still a student at Sir J.J. School of Art in 1984, Nigam began to build upon his artistic and printmaking practices. In art historian and artist Dr. Manisha Patil's writing about Nigam's abstract painting works, she mentions, "The self-imposed austerity of the formal language serves as a perfect foil to his quest for the mysteries of the universe." The artist attributes the intuitive understanding of surfaces to his prolific outputs as a printmaker. Printmaking techniques such as etching entails wiping of plates, which enhances skill of handling color areas. Not unlike graphic prints, Nigam's canvases have multi-layered surfaces with an intriguing place of textures, soft blurred images and defined contours, sudden depths and impulsive highlighted areas. In this above-mentioned paragraph, one can grasp the inner mind workings of the printmaker. become excels at the art of etching. His contributions to the process range not just in following a prescribed procedure, but also researching, experimenting, and developing numerous newer methods and fine-tuning a process which not many printmakers tend to use in printmaking. Nikam has been active in his art since the late 80s. Apart from having carved out a niche for himself as a vibrant and intense abstractionist, he has further taken his primary engagement with printmaking to multiple levels in the form of new works which employ multifarious uses of these techniques of printmaking. As a printmaker, and as a teacher of these techniques, this could be seen as a substantial contribution in the printmaking history of the country. As in some discourses regarding specific art practices connected to the printmaking in India, one was left wanting for more information and documentation. Nikam's fort is lino etching. This is a medium in which he has worked and exhibited for nearly 15 years now. This time frame has been evidence of the diligent efforts devoted towards honing a skill or a technique to its finest, also the mystery over the medium. In his works, one can see numerous inexplicable textural elements and surfaces which is not easily decipherable if one is not a printmaker. Probably, even if one were. Wash with water and rub with brush, clean the etching area. This kind of depth and intense treatments of a surface to extract the desired result is what the work of Nikam stands as a testament to. In an interview, he refers to the preoccupation in the earlier times with the formal language of printmaking. This probably urged the artist to look for more avenues in which a medium could be manipulated and explored. Today his work has become his statement more than any long-drawn explanation of a conventional creative process. The knowledge or understanding of the surface, its unseen textures and how something could be on the inside is a completely intuitive way of looking at it. Nikam in his quiet demeanor excels at this aspect with his innate ability towards recognizing a ground or surface to be worked upon, while his years of practice have anointed the artist with astute judgment of a substrate. While the printmaker learns these aspects only when he is in the art process, there are surprises which could either change the result or fail to deliver the desired result. Dry the block properly or keep it in sunlight. Clean the black japan with the help of kerosene or turpentine. Protection from acid solution. Nikam, with his extensive study and working in the process of lino etching, has developed enough raw material which has become his distinctive piezo language. Recalling his residency at Glasgow a few years back, he marvels at the infrastructure and freedom of expression that institutes abroad have for the artist and how they influenced the working of an artist's mind and enhanced output. Dry and clean the block properly. Although he praises these institutions for their possibilities in management of an art faculty, he believes that Indian artists have more talent as compared to others. Nikam has also spent a considerable number of years working at the Bharat Bhavan at Bhopal in his earlier years before joining Sir J.J. School of Art as a professor. The presence of veteran artist J. Swaminathan steadily influenced the thinking of the artist, and one could be reminded of the works of the when one does see the certain earlier print works of Nikam as well. The pattern of thought and observation of the world around and the inner world of the veteran artists has been passed on to Anant Nikam, and the artist works towards bringing the documentation of printmaking through his lino etched work for generations to come. After etching the first color image, take second color impression with the help of pinpoint registration mark. The work of Anant Nikam are available for view at Rupankar Museum of Fine Art, Bharat Bhavan, Bhopal, MP, National Gallery of Modern Art, New Delhi, Directorate of Art, Mumbai, Praxis Foundation, Mumbai, Government Museum of Chandigarh, Lalit Kala Academy, New Delhi. Anant Nikam lives and works in Mumbai. Safety and precaution. Safety procedures for handling of the itch solution and helpful tips on itching linoleum caution. The mixing, handling and etching of linoleum with sodium hydroxide crystals are extremely dangerous. To protect yourself and those around you from harm, please follow these instructions. Number 1. Always work in a well-ventilated area. If in a closed space, keep the windows open at all times. Number 2. Read the safety, handling instructions and caution labels on the sodium hydroxide crystal containers carefully. Number 3. Always wear acid-resistant gloves, safety goggles, apron and a respirator when handling acids. 4. In the case of an accident of your need of assistance, make sure someone else in the room is aware of what you are doing. 5. When mixing the sodium hydroxide crystals, it is important to remember to always put in the sodium hydroxide crystal into the water. Never add water to the sodium hydroxide crystals. Reversing this process could cause a furious reaction and perhaps an explosion. Prepare final registration diagonally, pinpoint, mark on Lino for reduction color printing. Ready the final print. 6. Should the itch solution splash or come in contact with the skin and is allowed to remain in contact with the skin, the result will be severe burn. It can be washed off immediately with plenty of water and follow these general guidelines. 7. Always keep a container of cold water nearby in case of an accident. If your skin comes in contact with the acid, wash the area immediately with plenty of cold water and soak for a minimum of 15 minutes. Get immediate medical attention. 8. If your eyes should come in contact, call for help and wash for eyes with running water for at least 15 minutes. Get immediate medical attention. 9. If your body should come in contact with the acid, wash your entire body with the hose from the draining sink for a minimum of 15 minutes. Get immediate medical attention. Mordants, acids and inks can be water-based or solvent-based, and hence care has to be taken that if a student has any respiratory allergies, asthma problems, appropriate aeration is provided for.